In macroeconomic statistics, entries are either recorded as economic flows or stock positions. We record these in the system of national accounts, external sector statistics, government finance statistics, and monetary and financial statistics. Macroeconomic statistics are designed to measure the stocks of and the changes in economic value. Stock positions measure economic value at a specific point in time. Flows measure the changes in economic value over a period of time. It is thus important to have an understanding of what economic flows and stocks are, how they relate to each other, and the different types of stocks and flows. Let us take a closer look at the integration of economic flows and stock positions in macroeconomic statistics. In all macroeconomic statistics, we record both stock positions and economic flows. We record stock positions in a balance sheet. But we can also record stock positions in other, more specialized accounts. For example, government debt statistics, external debt statistics, and in the national accounts, we record certain stocks in an input-output context. Economic flows appear in all accounts and tables of macroeconomic statistics. This includes the national accounts measuring production and consumption, the balance of payments measuring imports and exports of goods and services, and in government finance statistics, we measure government revenue, expenditure, and its financing. When both economic flows and stock positions are recorded in macroeconomic statistics, they are explicitly or implicitly integrated. In this sense, the changes in the stock positions between the two periods can be fully explained by the economic flows that are recorded between those two periods. With our dam filled with water analogy, the change in the level of water in the dam from the beginning to the end of the year can be fully explained by the water that flowed in and out of the pipes, as well as the rain and evaporation, and the leaking through a crack in the wall of the dam. Take, for example, the case where government decides to borrow from abroad to finance the deficit during a fiscal year. At the beginning of the year, the government has zero external debt liabilities. The stock position is zero. The borrowing is a flow that is recorded at the exchange rate prevailing at the time of the borrowing. Let's say the borrowing is equal to 100 in local currency. However, at the end of the fiscal year, the value of this external debt liability in government's balance sheet or in the debt tables may also have been affected by another flow. The exchange rate may be different from the one used at the time of the borrowing. The value of the stock position at the end of the period is thus not only the flow involving the borrowing itself, but also the effect of the higher or lower exchange rate. Let's say the effect of the exchange rate depreciation on the value of this loan is 10. So the change between the opening and closing balance sheet values of this external loan is explained by both these flows, the borrowing of 100 and the exchange rate effect of 10, which produces a closing balance sheet value of 110. The integration of stock positions and economic flows produces a complete and coherent macroeconomic framework that facilitates all kinds of economic analyses.